everyone. I hope you have been enjoying this series. And as we come to the last part of the series, I'm aware that there is so much more that I could have shared in this. And maybe another series, we may even explore this more and deeper. And it would be great to hear from you as to what is it that you would like more of. In today's session, I would like to come to bring this whole concept to closure and also give you some practice that might help you get in touch with the warrior in you. So, how do you get in touch with the warrior? Have you been able to recognize the warrior in you? And why do you want to reclaim it? You know, one of the intentions for me to reclaim my warrior was both for healing as well as for my own growth. And I realized how much of a help this warrior is, along with, of course, the other parts of me, my intelligence, the healer in me, and so many more. So as I went through my own journey of reclaiming the warrior in me, these are the things that I did. One of the things that has helped me is to look at places where I have experienced difficulty, where people I know have experienced difficulty. And I have tried to explore what kept them going. What were their beliefs? What were their feelings? What were their thoughts when they were going through all this? What made them get up again? What made them look for opportunities to help themselves? And then also look at what were the body positions while overcoming the difficulty. Now, it might be difficult because if the difficulty is already over, you don't really know what body postures you had. But when you think about it, when you think about that difficult situation, can you see what all your body goes through? As you are remembering the troubles, does your body shrink? As you are remembering what all you did and how you achieved success, does your body expand? And then look at this posture, this symbol that arises as a result of your success, of the times when maybe the situation didn't work in your favor, but you're alive today, you're willing to go ahead, you're watching different videos and looking at different ways of enhancing your knowledge and so on, which means there is some success that has happened for you. And therefore, can you actually describe this warrior? Can you acknowledge this warrior? Can you give this warrior a symbol? And can you look at it and experience it in your body? Through the series, I have tried to explore with you what all does the warrior require. So the warrior requires power. Then we also spoke about what takes away your power. And one very important aspect that takes away your power is your ability to or your intention to control things, to control others, and to focus on the results instead of focusing on the effort. It actually takes away your power, because then you're fighting something which is not under your control. Whereas if you start focusing on your efforts, you start focusing on what is it that you can do and what is it you cannot do, that can also help you look at retaining your power. So if you remember, in the very first session, I spoke about the six characteristics of a warrior. The first is shaurya, which loosely translated in English is courage. Shaurya is that part of you which allows you to stand up against fear. It is not an absence of fear. Rather, it is a presence of fear and your confidence that you can actually confront this fear. And that is why shaurya. Shaurya need not be something big. It need not be an enemy with a weapon. Shaurya can also be making a tough decision. Shaurya can also mean leaving a secure place and taking up a challenge. Shaurya can also mean stretching your own capacities to do something that you have never done before. And that is shaurya. But along with shaurya, a very, very important component is dhairya, which again loosely translated is patience. But dhairya comes from dhara. Dhara is earth. How the earth holds itself. it doesn't start spinning faster. If it starts, there will be no life. It doesn't suddenly stop. Slowly, it holds. And as we make efforts, as we stretch ourselves, we have to wait for things to start happening. We cannot expect things to happen in a day. We cannot expect things to happen immediately. So how do you develop patience? One of the very good ways of increasing both patience and courage is to focus on your breath. Slow your breath. Focus on your breath. Look at how the breath comes in, how it goes out. The slower you are, the more clarity it will provide. And the more clarity it will provide, your courage and your patience will be directed on the right places. Patience and tolerance cannot be overstretched. You cannot go on tolerating or being patient in the name of being patient. You also need to know when the limit of the patience is over. You also need to know how much courage you are going to show. Then you come to dharma. Dharma, though I mentioned in the first video as righteousness, essentially dharma is knowing what is it that is required of you. What are really your duties, or what is something you are picking up in the name of duty? Are you becoming codependent in the name of duty? What is it that as an individual you need to do? What is your responsibility? That is your dharma. And following your dharma is another aspect of the warrior in you. Then is karma, which is you have to go on taking small action. One step at a time. But continuous action, so that your skills are constantly updated. You're constantly in that practice. So that is your karma. Then we come to the last two, which are very important. And as I said before, we talked about power. We also talked about self-compassion and self-care, which is self-care is more about the dharma and the karma, and self-compassion, which is about Raudra and Kshama. Though loosely I have translated Raudra as anger, Raudra is essentially that element in you which protects you, which draws boundaries, which does not allow people to simply step into something, which allows you to enforce rules, which allows you to say no. That Raudra, your ability to show that you are not going to put up with this, and you're not going to tolerate this, and this is your dharma and you're going to stick to it, and this is the action you're going to take even if it makes you very, very unpopular. That Raudra is also important. And Kshama. Now Kshama, when I say forgiveness, because of the current lot of misunderstanding around it, forgiveness almost becomes like you made a mistake and I am going to forgive you. No, that is not about the warrior. The warrior is, I have expanding myself. I will take the necessary action if you have wronged me. I will show the necessary patience. I will show the necessary Raudra. But I will expand myself so that I don't hold a grudge. So that I am expanded enough that your presence or your action doesn't impact. That is what is Kshama. Kshama is again, comes from the word sham, which is holding. Can I hold more of what happens to me in my body, in my psyche, without getting impacted? So a warrior, when you reclaim your warrior, you are reclaiming all these six characteristics. And you are showing up in the world using these six characteristics. And one very, in the mythology, one very, very important example of all these six characteristics is the character of Sita. She has Shaurya. She is able to stand up to Ravan. She has Dhairya. She is willing to wait for that many years for Ram to come. She has Dharma. She is very clear about what she will do and what she will not do. She is doing small karmas. She is praying. She is doing things. She is taking care of herself. She is showing Raudra when it becomes important. And then she is also expansive. She is not revengeful. She is not vengeful. So And of course, I know a lot of examples of men and women around me who show all these six characteristics in different ways. You would want to reflect on your own life where you have shown all these six. That is why I said reclaiming and not creating, because I know that there is a warrior in you. It might be a question of really understanding it, nurturing it, and claiming it and showing up. I hope you like this series. I hope it was meaningful. And I'm hopeful that in the coming months, I might do another series with these six characteristics, going more deeper and bringing in more practice. Thank you very much. I hope that you will practice this and also share with me your experiences.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.